Hey guys, welcome to Boho Salon. I'm Lady Lagslot, and I'm going to help you guys learn how to get a job at Boho Salon. And this way, you'll be able to design people, do hair, the tanning beds, whatever you want to do, including yourself. So I hope you guys enjoy it, and if you did, please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next video. Okay, so once you've logged into your account, go to Boho Salon, like you're about to play it, and go to the About section. And once you've gone to this About section, go to the group, go to this link, and it'll bring you to this group. What you have to do is there's a button over here that says Join Group, join the group, and then push this button. Yours will say Make Primary or Add as Primary, something like that. Click that button. And then once you have that, then you can go back to this link over here and you can go to apply for a job. And once you've made it there, you just play it like you were going to play any other game. Now, once you've made it into the game, it will start to load right here and it'll say searching for job rank, and then you should be able to click start. And then you'll be able to select a job. So, it really doesn't matter which job you pick. Whichever job you pick, you'll be able to do everything that everything can do. But the difference is there's different amount of questions. You can see spa technician has 10, the rest of them have 20. And most of them are simple questions like, if someone is rude to you, what do you do? And the right answer is very obvious. So it's really not that difficult. And then there's only, like, not even 10 technical questions on how to actually do your job. So you would click one of the jobs, and then you fill out the questions. And then you should be able to go straight to Boho Salon and get started with your job. And then you can just leave the game. It'll look like it's loading for an eternity, but just leave. Now that you've done that, you can go play. Okay, so now that you guys have learned how to apply for a job, I'm going to show you how to do your job by using my brother's character. And you may be wondering why I changed my hair. I had to change servers because the game is so busy. Anyway, I'm going to start showing you how to do your job. I'm going to have to move him after I get there. So I'll show you as much as I can by myself. First, I'll give you a tour. This is kind of like the general waiting area. This is where, when you get a job here, you can go back here and you can work at these cashiers and you can get cards for people. And cards enable you to actually do stuff to their character. It allows you to edit their character. So what you do is you push F, and then you put in their name here. It has to be exactly the same as their real username. So I'm going to use my brother for an example. So Marine 101, and then right here you say they want purple hair. You can write purple hair, and then the stylist will be able to do that. Or you can just write makeover. That's what I usually do, especially when they know what they're doing and they just want the card. So once you hit submit, apparently he has to get closer. Let me go find, here, he's coming in. I'm doing this from across the room. There he is. So he's standing right there. There. So now he just got the card. So now that enables me to edit him, basically. So if I pushed a button on his computer. This is so weird. So anyway, if I push this, well, in order to do it, you need to take out this iPad thing in the second slot, and you just need to touch their card. Now it says you can serve Marine 101, and they can put away their card. So now, you can edit them. So first, after they have a card, you can head over back here. And there's two rooms back here. Over here is washing and drying area. And over here are the tanning beds. Then, And those, usually those aren't used, and if you do end up using them, usually it's after the makeover, because that's just the way it works. So if you want to style them, head out the store and go upstairs. And up here are tons of chairs. And more, another cashier. So if someone forgot a card, you can always do it up here. But yeah, there are plenty of seats. It doesn't matter which seat you go in. You can go in whatever seat you want. And yeah, I'll show you how to do that later though. First, let's do hair and, well, washing and drying hair. So let's head over here. Head, blah, cannot talk. I'm so sorry. Let's go over here and I'll get my brother over here. Well, his character. Okay, so once the person is sitting in the chair, then you can push F and interact. F is the main thing to interact with any device. So if you can interact with it, just get up close to it and push F, and then the menu will pop up. And also, in order to, you can open this menu whenever you want to, but in order to do the action, someone has to be sitting in the chair, which is kind of a bummer if someone gets confused and jumps out of the chair. Anyway, these green arrows move the chair. At least they used to. Yeah, there they go. So you can see it's moving. Gotta do it slowly. So you could push them forward or backwards, but this doesn't really matter too much. It might just add to the roleplay a little bit. You can scooch them back like that. And then there's some bubbles, some fancy bubbles. You just spam the button, or you can just push it once, and bubbles will appear. It's a cool roleplay device, but again, it serves no purpose. Next is the hair drying station. And the sad thing about this, I can't even show you. It doesn't do anything. Again, it just serves as a roleplay purpose. You just sit here, and you can't do anything with it. And then you get stuck. Oh, there you go. Alright, so the next thing we'll do is the tanning beds. Okay, so now we're in the tanning rooms, and my brother's character is in the tanning bed. The bummer thing is you kind of have to stand on their head to get it to the menu to pop up. So once you get to the menu to pop up, you click this icon right here, and you can choose a color. Now, a pale tone like the one we have right now is this pastel brown. The colors are named weird, but yeah, it's this pastel brown. The colors are really tricky to figure out. Like, you might think this is a tan. It's really not. It's extremely hard. This is very pink, but I'll just show you. This might be a tan. Then you get this little device once you've selected a color and push submit, and you just click. It closes the lid, and they get colored a different color. So once he emerges, so that's a little dark. That was, for reference, dark orange. I think it was this one or that one. I'm really not sure. But yeah, you can do whatever color you want. You can do, oh, this is toothpaste. You can do whatever color you want, like they were, or just a regular tone like this. There's another tone that's a little bit more pink than this. See, there he is, blue. So there's a more pinky version of this. There's a few, actually. But I'm just going to go back to the one that I already have. And get him back to a presentable color. There. Now he's back to normal. There's also some cashiers in here, so you can give them a card if they forget, or if it gets used, or when you reset, the card disappears, so that might affect them, and yeah. So now, I'm gonna go upstairs, and yeah, I'll start styling my brother. Alright, so let's head upstairs and style my brother. Well, his character. I keep saying that. But another thing I wanted to say is rank doesn't matter. I probably said this already, but I'm rank 9, which is the highest rank you can get to until you have, I think it's 500 points, and then you can get like this super rank. The way you get points is you style people, you give them cards and stuff like that, but it doesn't matter which chair you sit in. You can sit in any chair of these and it will work. But my brother's over here, so we're gonna go over here. So, again, have your person sit in the chair. At this point, usually, you'll ask them to hold out their card, and you can scan their card, and once you've done that, then you can style them. So you push F, I'm going to go over here so we can actually see. Now, this is where it gets a little difficult. So, in order to basically remove their clothes, you can use this options button, and you remove the face, is the expression on their face, the smiles, the eyes, stuff like that. Pants, self-explanatory. Shirt, self-explanatory. T-shirt, is the top layer. So if they have that weird Roblox block thing, I think you can just say remove t-shirt and it'll remove it, like it just did. So, oh, and hat, sadly this gets rid of everything. So hair, glasses, his headphones, it gets rid of everything. Now, remove package is, I'll just show you, it removes the body. So there are other bodies you can put, but it removes the body. The old way, there was no options button on the older version. This is version 3, I think. But the way you used to do it is you type remove. Wow, that is totally how you spell remove. Remove, I'm so bad at typing. Remove hat. And then it would remove hat. So you go back in here. And the way you actually put clothes and stuff on people is you go into the catalog and you can search by category. You can look up different themes, different names. Like if you have an outfit you love, like I do, I just search rainbow and I find all my rainbow outfits and stuff like that. So let's get Lucas's body type back. We can go to packages, and there are a ton of different packages here. There's Halloween stuff, there's zombies, there's superheroes, but Robloxian 2.0 is the main body style. So I usually do that. But we could always, if you're doing a costume, you could do superhero, there's penguins, there's suits of armor, there's like tentacles. There's a ton of cool stuff in here. This is also another popular outfit. It's kind of like Elsa. A lot of people like it. Don't tell my brother I put him in a dress. But, yeah, this is the most... Yeah. Oh, look at his legs! Oh my gosh, that's hilarious! Okay, so, yeah, don't tell my brother I did this to his character. But again, you just remove package, and it removes that. But we're just... Oh my gosh, there's a chicken. Shh, don't tell him. We're gonna do this. Mark. Oh my gosh. That's awesome. A lot of mean people use this as a troll, and they'll just walk up next to you and put stupid packages on. So if they do stuff like this, like add a chicken body, just do remove package. Sure, it'll end up like this block character, but all you do is you just go to Roblox 2.0 right there on the first page and submit. I forgot that part. You have to submit to make the command happen. Alright, so now that we've done all that, let's get to actually styling him. So, let's go for just a cool look. Let's do blue. His favorite color is blue. So, I'm just gonna do blue. So, say I wanted to look for blue hair. I can do blue, and it'll find blue hair. And some of these are really cool, actually. A lot of it involves looking through this catalog button right here and finding cool stuff for your person. Or, well, whoever you're styling. So that's why it kind of takes a while to do one person. You gotta look through and find good stuff. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. There we go. Alright, ooh, let's do this. Midnight Shaggy. So once you find something you like, you click on it. Then you have to push Get ID. Now this over here is you can change the color, which I'm not going to do yet, so we can just see it without. So don't touch this menu if you don't want to color it, and just do submit. Now you'll get scissors in your hand, and all you have to do is you click it 5 times, I think. Each time it goes up a certain amount, you see it even more. So if you want to do, like if you already have a cool hat on and stuff, and you just want to see the hair, then only go up to like 80%, so you can, get a look of the hair, but not make it permanent, so you don't have to remove everything and put everything back on. So, like, just ask people if they like this, so they can kind of see the basic shape, and if they do, you can go ahead and click it for the last time and do 100%, and then it'll become completely Clear. Well, there. So, say they don't like this. They're like, I don't like the color. Can you switch the color? So, first you have to take off the old one. So, remove hat. And then, you do the same thing as before. Click the hair. Get ID. Now, oh, I love this song. But now you can adjust the color. So, you just click in the general area. Okay. So, to get the general color, you can click anywhere. And then, to get a little bit more finer tuning, hold it down and you can go up. And it goes up to white, or down, and over to the left. And you can do this until you find the perfect color. You could even adjust here if you want it a little darker, or a little brighter, then you can do that. Usually I don't deal with the brightness. Your real color is going to come from here. So, you push use color. See, and it says color chosen. You can click this to cancel. And then you push submit. And it'll look like the same as before. Except this time, as you start to put it on, it's going to be black. The reason why it does that is because first you have to put the hair on, and then you have to color it. But don't worry, you don't have to go in any menu to color it. Once you do 100% of the cutting, or just putting it on there, then you get a spray can, do the same exact thing. You just click it 5 times, and it'll slowly start spray painting it whatever color you selected in the menu. I think this is a cool audition. I was kind of confused when it was black, but I think it's a cool addition, spray painting someone's hair. Alright. So then once you do that, you get points. See, now I have 91. I started with 88. When you give people cards, you get every 2 cards you hand out, you get 1 point. Hair, you get 1 card, and then when you color it, you get 2 cards. And, yeah. And then the more points you get, once you get, I think, 500, there's like a super rank. I haven't seen anyone with the super rank yet, but I've seen people close to it. Alright, so now that we have this hair, so let's just pretend he likes it. Well, pretend I like it since I'm here designing it. I don't really like it, but that's okay. So now, if you're in a theme search that you did, you can go back to hats, just click on it, and it'll bring you back here. Now you can search through here if you want to. You can scroll up and down, you can find stuff that a lot of people have been using, or that you've been using, stuff like that. Now, when it says hats up here, it's a little bit deceiving, because this is anything. It's wings, it's rubber duckies, apparently. It's a shoulder sloth, backpacks, the guitar, anything. And everything in the hats menu can be colored. So, here, I'll show you these cool wings. These are angel wings. So just search angel, and then click angel wings, get ID. Don't mess with that, don't worry, it won't color it green. It'll just do the regular color. And then you push submit, and it'll put it on. Yes, these wings have particles, that's why it's glowing like that. So, I'm not going to leave these wings on. So this is what I mean by just do it up to 80%. That way they can kind of see what it looks like before you set it in stone. If they don't like it, then you just push 3 down here in your hotbar, and it goes away. So, that saves you a lot of trouble. So now that we have hair, let's go to faces. There are a ton of faces. You can look up emotions, like, I'm probably spelling this wrong. Queasy? Yeah, I spelled it wrong. But beast mode, trouble, I'm using smiling girl right now. There's a different version of smiling girl, too. There's bubbles. There's a cute butterfly. There's the butterfly. Super happy face. There is, here, anime eyes. It's actually galaxy. I use these a lot too. I'm just going to put this on so you can see it. Yeah, same as hats. You click it, get ID, submit, and it appears. Now, faces, you don't have to remove them if you put on a different one. So, I click faces again so I can get back to the main menu. Say I want to do this because he's a little troublemaker. I'm gonna click Just Treble, get ID, and submit, and you don't have to remove the faces. Which, I don't like that face. Let's switch to a different face. We'll work on that later. Okay, so now let's find some shirts and pants. So, you can find just shirts in this menu, or just pants in this menu. But as you can see, pants, for most of the time it's just girls, any girl outfits, pants have a shirt as well, and it comes as a full outfit, like mine. Mine is a full outfit under that I found under pants. So I actually do a lot of my searching in pants, since most of the people I do are girls. But if you wanted to, you could just get these cool pants. You can look them up by name. You don't have to just do theme in that top menu. You can just find these green pants. Same as before, I could look up green. Here, I'll do that in shirts. Let's find a cool shirt. Let's do green. See? And then I get cool green stuff. Like, that's cool. That looks like my shirt, actually. There's Green Lantern. That's kind of cool. There's a ton of good stuff here. Like this. I think I'm going to choose this. This matches. There. But say you wanted it to be more precise. You could do green... Blech, cords everywhere. Hang on. Green... hoodie. If I spelled that right. Pretty sure I did. Yeah, there we go. So there's a bunch of different hoodies here. That looks like Steve from Blue's Clues. Sorry. But it's true. It looks like Steve from Blue's Clues. But anyway, that way you're a little bit more precise if someone asks for a specific thing. Like if they ask for green hoodie, then you can look this up and find it a little bit more easily than just searching green and finding it. The only problem with the search is you have to be precise, but not extremely precise. Like, unless they give you a name of a shirt that you can look up, just kind of be a little bit specific, but not down to the point. Like, green hoodie with headphones, that most likely won't work. Like, this is all you'd probably get. So, yeah. And it all depends on what each outfit is named. So if it's not named Green Hoodie, then it won't come up. So sometimes you do have to just look up green and find stuff. Other times you have to look up Green Hoodie and then you'll find stuff. Okay, so now that we have all of that, say they've done this and they're like, I want a little bit more. There's something I'm missing. You could be like, okay, do you want headphones or a hat or glasses? Stuff like that. So let me look up, wow, I spelled that right, didn't I? This wasn't working earlier. Yeah, it's not working. Okay. Ooh, look at these shades. Let's do these shades. So you can look up shades, or you can look up glasses. It looks like you're cutting your hair, but their hair, but you're really not. Any hat that you put on is gonna have those scissors. So, just go with it. And if you color this, then it'll show up black, and then you'll get the spray can after you've done cut it. Wow, English. Blech. Okay. So let's finish this and see how it looks. There. See, and I got a point. So now I have 92 points. Wow, I almost have 100. That's cool. Alright, so now he's looking beautiful. I always tell them when I'm done, if they stick around long enough, that they look beautiful. Or amazing. I say amazing most of the time. But yeah. That's an outfit done. Now, if you want to do yourself, same thing. You just hop in the chair, push F. And you can mess with yourself. You don't need a card or anything. You can just do it to yourself. But yeah, that's how you do your job. I'll just explain a few more things before I let you guys get going. This over here, this is the newest update. It is a show, fashion show. It's pretty self-explanatory. The category, the category is flowers or flower. So people, if you look around, you'll probably actually see people with flower outfits and stuff. But yeah, you have 20 minutes to come up with your outfit or your client's outfit. And then you have 2 minutes, I think, to vote. And the winner appears out here on this podium. It's just a mannequin, but yeah, it says the category you won and their username. And it shows our character. So it's pretty cool. I haven't won any though. A lot of people just join the show, and they haven't even been styled yet. So there's a lot of random stuff in there, but overall, so I haven't won any is what I'm trying to say, but eventually someone will get some, a person who deserves it will win. Most likely someone will. Like it says, you can only do one outfit per round, so you can only push submit outfit once, then it completely disappears, and you cannot submit anymore, and that's final, unless you leave, of course. Over here, if people are waiting, like, say you've done a client, and they're like, okay, now what do I do until the fashion show, or the show? Excuse me. What you can tell them to do is just head over here, and over here, there's a little volleyball net. Wow, a pit. You can run into the ball, and you can pick up a ball, and your character does a little... Yeah. I don't know. Can you pick this one back up, I wonder? Yeah, you can. Sweet. So you can actually play volleyball with people. I mean, it wouldn't really be complete, but yeah. So basically, to start your job and actually get a client... Thankfully, there's no one over here. Wow, there is no one over here. So anyway, if you want to style someone, just head back here. Wait for someone to show up. You can talk to them. Say, hey, how was your... I always do. Hi, how can I help you? Wow, how can I help you? There. And then you just kind of wait until someone shows up. Then you can say, hi, how can I help you? They'll say, hey, can I have a card? And you can be sure. You can be like, sure. You give them a card, and then usually they go in the back and sit in these chairs. So, after that, you can find someone in the chairs, and you can say, hey, can I help you today? And then you can help them. Hi, how can I help? Ooh, I'm so good at spelling today. Alright, so you just go star LIGHJ makeover. Oh, great. I'm so good at this. There. So then, basically, that's how you do it. And then they just leave and they sit in a chair. Then, once someone is sitting in a chair, you can be like, hey, can I help you today? And then you tell them, follow me. And you can go upstairs and do your job. So I'll help someone, but I'll do it in a time lapse so you guys can see it without annoying texting, because it does involve a lot of texting, and it takes a lot of time and patience, especially patience. That's one thing, because you want them to have an outfit that they like. So it does take a lot of patience to find an outfit that they like. Yeah, one thing I always keep in mind is the client is always right. So whether you like it or not, you do what they want, not what you want. I mean, it's their character. So yeah, just something to keep in mind. We'll be right back. Alright. And that's how you do a person. You just talk to them, ask them what kind of style hair they want, what length, what color, if they want a face or makeup, if you're role-playing, an outfit, you can add a tail, wings, glasses, anything you like. So, if you found this video helpful, or if you enjoyed it, then please leave a like and subscribe for more gaming content. I will see you guys later.